Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome. This Wednesday of the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time, the 13th week in Ordinary Time. Our entrance hymn is in your music issue, if you have it, hopefully, number 582, Companions on the Journey. And we're ready to begin, so please stand. Companions on the journey, breaking bread and sharing life. And in the love we bear is the hope we share, for we believe in the love of our God. We believe in the love of our God. No longer strangers to each other, no longer strangers in God's house. We are fed and we are nourished by the strength of those who care, by the strength of those who care. We are companions on the journey, breaking bread and sharing life. And in the love called by the word of the Lord to act with justice, to love tenderly, and to walk humbly with our God, to walk humbly with our God. Your companions on the journey, breaking bread and sharing life, in the love of our God.
We certainly do. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
Grace and peace of God our Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, be always with you.
And with your spirit.
This is the way church should be, you know, not through a tell-ins, but rather in presence. And the Lord calls us indeed, my friends, to draw to one another, but most especially to draw closer to Him, because we often allow so many things to get in the way. And yet we are so sure about ourselves many a times that we will never let anything get in the way of the love of God. But if we reflect a little bit, just like the gospel today, we realize that a lot of the things are because we let them get in the way. So we ask the Lord for wisdom to recognize those things, for courage to say no, and also for that valiant heart to be steadfast in our love for God. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O O God, who by your ineffable mercy have been pleased through the labors of your priest, Blessed Junipero Serra, to count many American peoples within your church, grant by his intercession that we may so join our hearts to you in love, as to carry always and everywhere before all people the image of your only begotten Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Seek good and not evil, that you may live. Then truly will the Lord, the God of hosts, be with you as you claim. Hate evil and love good, and let justice prevail at the gate. Then it may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will have pity on the remnants of Joseph. I spurn your feasts, says the Lord. I take no pleasure in your solemnities. Your cereal offerings I will not accept, nor consider your stall-fed peace offerings. Away with your noisy songs. I will not listen to the melodies of your harps. But if you would offer burnt offerings, then let justice surge like water and goodness like an unfailing stream. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God. To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Hear my people, and I will speak. Israel, I will testify against you. God, your God am I.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
For mine are all the animals of the forest, beasts by the thousands on my mountains. I know all the birds of the air, and whatever stirs in the plains belongs to me.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
If I were hungry, I should not tell you, for mine are the world and its fullness. Do I eat the flesh of strong bulls, or is the blood of goats my drink?
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you?
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Alleluia,
that we may be a kind of first fruits of his creatures. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus came to the territory of Gadarenes, two demoniacs who were coming from the tombs met him. They were so savage that no one could travel by that road. They cried out, "What have you to do with us, Son of God? Have you come here to torment us before the appointed time?" Some distance away, a herd of many swine was feeding. The demons pleaded with him, "If you drive us out, send us into the herd of swine." And he said to them, "Go then." They came out and entered the swine, and the whole herd rushed down the steep bank into the sea, where they drowned. The swineherds ran away, and when they came to the town, they reported everything, including what had happened to the demoniacs. Thereupon, the whole town came out to meet Jesus, and when they saw him, they begged him to leave their district. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
This is one of those readings where you really question, you know, that last phrase, the Gospel of the Lord, the good news of God. Because it makes me question, because the people rejected Jesus. They threw him out of the district, not even out of their town, but out of that whole area. They didn't want him because they saw lost their herd. They preferred to live with their demons. They preferred to leave disconnected from the rest of the community. They preferred their herds rather than the communion, than the unity. And I was reflecting upon that, and I was thinking, is that me? Is that me that, you know, I prefer to live with the comforts and with the things that I like, and the things I don't want to let go of, rather than to be in communion with God, rather to have the communion with my brothers and sisters? That sometimes we need to really think about this, because we say we want to live in peace, but what does it take us to live in peace? It may mean that I'm going to have to sacrifice a great deal. Well, maybe not that kind of peace. What kind of peace are you looking for? Todos queremos ir al cielo, ¿verdad? Nobody wants to die. We want to get rid of the virus, but we continue doing those things that contract and that spread the virus. Is that me, a person of contradiction? I want to go in the direction that God is calling me. I want to serve. I want to be at peace in my heart. And I truly want to worship. And I truly want to come to know your divine will in my life, Lord. But up to where? Where do I put that obstacle? Where do I put it back and to say, well, I ask him and I ask him and I pray and I've been praying for years. But I don't know why he doesn't listen to me. Maybe the answer is on me. Maybe he's waiting for my decision. Because I am sure that Jesus wants us all to be free of all the obstacles in our life. All the disease, all the pain, all the hurt, all the brokenness. Maybe he's waiting on us. Because only those decisions we can make. Today, my friends, I'd like to ask us to truly reflect on the prophet's words, hate evil, love the good. Learn to remove and to have the courage and the wisdom to recognize, and what is that evil in my life that I need to remove and I need to say no to and I need to reject so that I can truly love God and learn to love the good. My brothers and sisters, embracing righteousness and hoping in God's mercy, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's people may offer a pleasing sacrifice of praise, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may be a fountain of righteousness, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
The waters of justice may cleanse the nations of greed and injustice, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the suffering poor may behold God's graciousness, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the sick may know the presence of the God of hosts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our love of goodness may spill out of our homes and churches and into our communities, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the dead may find mercy at the gates of the heavenly Jerusalem, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray also for the eternal repose of Carlota Pacheco and the repose souls of all souls, we pray to the Lord. Source of goodness, you turn your back on empty worship, accepting only the sacrifice of righteousness. Pour out upon us the boundless waters of your justice, that we may become fountains of your love for the sake of your kingdom, where Jesus Christ lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is 488 in the music issues. Center of my life, 488. Oh Lord, you are the center of my life. I will love. the center of my life. I will always praise you. I will always serve you. I will always keep you in my sight. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm. O Lord, you are the center of my life. I will always praise you. I will always serve you. I will always keep you in my sight.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, and my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, good of all the soul and church.
Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, on this memorial of Blessed Junipero Serra, and grant that we, who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion, may imitate what we now do. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. giving thanks that you have held us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop, the clergy and religious everywhere. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles, Blessed Junipero Serra, Saint Patrick, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Let us turn to our loving fathers, a loving Father, with our sincere hearts as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and in your mercy, grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with one another a sign of God's peace.
Agnus Dei,
qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold, this is the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are we to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is 368 in the music issue, Bread of Life, 368.
And let us pray. By the power of this mystery, O Lord, confirm your servants in the true faith, that they may everywhere profess in word and deed the faith for which blessed Junipero Serra never ceased to labor and for which he spent his whole life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and keep you. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, descend upon you, remain with you forever. Amen. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love, to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great evening. We'll see you mañana con el favor de Dios. God bless you. Be safe. Huh? Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Our recessional hymn is 616 in the music issue. We are called. 616.
Come live in the light. Shine with the joy and the love of the Lord. We are called to be light for the kingdom, to live in the freedom of the city of God. We are called to act with justice. We are called to love tenderly. We are called to serve one another, to walk humbly with God. Come, open your heart. Serve one another.